In the previous video, we discussed how the neuron calculates the vibe rate by the summation operation, but we didn't discuss about the right side of this neuron, which is the activation operation. If you haven't seen that video, I will recommend you to see that first so you can connect with this video. Suppose you wake up in the morning, open the window, and it's cloudy outside. You will think in your mind that it may rain today, but you want to go outside for some work. So you check the weather on Google, and Google tells you the chances of rain in percentage. As per the prediction, you will decide to carry an umbrella or not. I know carrying an umbrella is a drag. So this kind of prediction is done using activation functions. Generally, activation functions have two use cases. First is to enable our model to fit on non-linear data, and the second is to check if a particular neuron is firing or not. So let's check out, can we really fit on non-linear data after using activation functions? First, I have created a linear data function which will make linear data for us. The input matrix x is nothing but values arranged from 0 to 50, and the y is the transformation from the linear data function. You can see the graph of this. It is completely linear data. So let us fit the model on this data without any activation functions, and let's see what happens. I have created a model with only one neuron. If you don't know what is the sequential and compile thing means, just ignore it and focus on the end result for now. We will be discussing all this in depth in future videos. After training, you can see this red line has completely fitted to our linear data. Good. Now let's create non-linear data. As you can see, now our data is not linear, it is curvy. And if we fit our model on this data, it has completely screwed up. We want a red line to also curve with data, but it is rigid. But when we use activation functions, you can see this activation equal to ReLU thing here. Something happens and our line fits the data. Now it has curved with the data as well as it could. So this was the power of activation functions. When we work with real world data, it is way more complex than this. So activation functions are almost every time required. But how does the activation functions do that? We derived the formula of vibe rate in the previous video, but it wasn't enough to fit on non-linear data, or we can say on complex data. But when we introduce the activation functions to our vibe rate, things get pretty non-linear. So just by adding this, the accuracy of our model has blasted up. In the deep learning market, there are many activation functions, but ReLU is the most used of all of them. ReLU, which means rectified linear unit, takes the vibe rate and does some kind of transformation to it, and that transformation is this. You can see in the algebraic form of ReLU that all the values which are negative in vibe rate are mapped straight to 0 and the positive values are kept unchanged. To put it easily, assume this matrix is to be activated. It goes through ReLU activation and it will become like this. You can see all the negative values are mapped to 0 and all the positives are kept unchanged. If we see it graphically, things are quite simple. On the negative axis, the line is at 0 because every negative value is mapped to 0. But on the positive side, the line just goes straight ahead. If we take 1 and see the output, it will be 1. And the same for every value from 1 to infinity. Now when you know how ReLU does the transformation, but how does this transformation results in non-linearity? Suppose you have a data like this. It is completely non-linear, and if we try to fit on this data using ReLU, we can do that. First, we will shift the line upwards. As we discussed in the previous video, we can do that by using bias. Now we have fitted the data on left. Now to fit on these points, we will stretch our line towards the left. Simply, instead of making all negative 0, we will make all points till minus 1, 0. Now to fit on the right side, we will take part of this line which is above 2 and set its slope to 0. Amazing, we have completely fitted on the data. Without activation functions, we wouldn't be able to fit on this data ever. Now enough of the ReLU, let's explore other activation functions like sigmoid, or also known as logistic. If you are familiar with machine learning, there is an entire algorithm, logistic regression, based entirely on sigmoid activation. Sigmoid activation takes any value and squishes it in the range 0 to 1. And because of this phenomenon, sigmoid activation is used for classification. At the start of this video, we saw a classification example in which our model has to decide that it will rain or not rain. Suppose 0 means it will not rain and 1 means it will rain. Then our sigmoid can tell the probability of raining. Assume this dot is prediction of our model. Currently it is on 0.5, which means the model is 50% sure that it will rain. So that point can be anywhere between 0 to 1, and that's how it can tell the probability of rain. The second use of activation functions was to see a particular neuron is firing or not. We can tell that using sigmoid activation. Let's make a simple neuron that accepts one feature as input and outputs the prediction. Currently, the value of the sigmoid is at 0. That means this neuron is not firing at all. If we make it 1, that means the neuron is firing with its maximum strength. And that's how it works. The last type of activation we will discuss is softmax activation. It is not like the previous activation we discussed because it cannot be expressed in graphical form. There is a prerequisite for using softmax activation, which are you should only use softmax activation when you are dealing with a classification problem. And second, it is only used in the output neurons. Softmax takes a set of any real values and transform them into a probability distribution. As you can see, if you sum up this matrix, it will be always 1. Just let it go if you are not understanding this now, as softmax will be coming many times in future videos of this series. It will be clear then. You almost know how these activation functions work, but we haven't discussed which activation to use from all of this. Almost all the time you will use ReLU as your first choice, but even ReLU sometimes sucks because it zeros every negative value. So sometimes every value in the output matrix becomes so close to zero that the neuron eventually dies and does not do any active contribution to the neural network. To tackle this problem, many other activation functions like leaky ReLU, ELU, SELU were made. So I recommend you to learn more about this from the links given in the description. So that's it for today's video. Until the next video, see my other videos. And if you are from the very future, I may have already uploaded many videos in this series. So you can get the playlist link in the description and many other useful resources. Thanks for watching.